We want to solve the given log equation for x in terms of a and b. So the main goal here is to combine the right side of the equation into a single natural log. If we can do this, we can then solve for x. The idea here is if we have the natural log of m equal to the natural log of n, we can then conclude that m is equal to n. So again, our goal here is to combine the right side into a single natural log using the properties of logarithms. To do this, we'll first have to clear the parentheses. So we'll go ahead and distribute here and here, as well as here and here. So we'll have the natural log of x equals 2 natural log a plus 2 natural log b plus 4 natural log b to the fourth plus 3 natural log b minus 3 natural log a. Now before we combine these logarithms into a single logarithm, all the coefficients must be 1. So now we can apply the power property of logarithm, meaning we can take these coefficients and move them to the exponent position here, 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 and here. So now we'll have the natural log of x equals natural log a squared plus natural log b squared plus, and then here, since we already have an exponent of 4 here, if we have b to the fourth, we raise that to the fourth power. When we have powers to powers, we multiply. So this is going to be equal to b to the 16th. So this becomes natural log b to the 16th plus natural log b to the third minus natural log a cubed. Now we can start combining these logarithms. Notice these first four logarithms are connected by addition, so we can combine them into a single log by multiplying the number of parts of the logs, or multiplying a to the second, b to the second, b to the 16th, and b to the third. So we'd have the natural log of x equals the natural log of, we'd have a to the second, and then b to the second times b to the 16th would be b to the 18th, times b to the third would be b to the 21st. We still have minus natural log a to the third. Now because we have a difference here, we can combine these two logs by dividing the number of parts of the logs. So we'll have a to the second, b to the 21st, divided by a to the third as a number part of the log. So we'll have x equals natural log of a to the second, b to the 21st, divided by a to the third. Notice here we have a to the second over a to the third. So two factors of a will simplify out. This will simplify to 1. This will simplify to a to the first. So finally we have natural log x equals natural log of b to the 21st all over a. Now because we have these two natural logs equal to each other, x must equal b to the 21st divided by a. Which would be our solution in terms of a and b. So this is a little bit of a strange equation, but it is a good exercise on applying the properties of logarithms.